when I was child diving in the southern coast of Tunisia, I remember huge quantities of fish. Now this is not visible anymore.
Big groupers were common in the Mediterranean Sea in the 1940s. Then the population dropped. Grouper fish populations were affected by overfishing. Fishermen suffered when the plentiful marine resources vanished. Only empty sea bottoms were left. New pressures on the Mediterranean marine biodiversity have also been caused by the growth of cities, coastal recreation, harbors, industries, maritime transportation. And the industrialized agriculture. The need for efficient marine conservation measures has become evident in the Mediterranean. At this meeting in Malta, the first marine protected area of the country is being created. The users, decision makers and conservation specialists collaborate closely. This approach is called integrated management. Because the area has different uses, many people have important knowledge to contribute.
The main pressures in this site are mainly involving recreational activities such as boating, anchoring, diving and illegal picking of organisms and even fisheries.
In Malta, underwater spearfishing has had a heavy toll on the grouper populations. The new marine park is expected to help in the sound management of the biodiversity. In Foča in Turkey, these small-scale fishermen have actively participated in the creation of a marine protected area. Industrial fishing has been controlled in order to make the survival of the small-scale fisheries possible. The conservation of the endangered monk seal has been assisted by the recovery of the fish populations.
Well, when we come here the first time, we found out that the seals are very important to conserve in the area. And in order to conserve the seals, we need to keep the local fish stocks in a good, steady condition. And in order to do that, we need to get also the support of the local fishermen and the local people. And we worked on that matter, and then local small-scale fishermen also supported us from the beginning. And then this is why it became also a more successful project in Foča. If you would like to carry out a conservation project in a small area or a big area, doesn't matter. If you don't involve the local stakeholders and the local interested groups to conserve such an ecosystem or a species, you cannot succeed. Therefore, it's very important to get the support of locals. And in our Foča case, it is the small-scale fishermen who are working in the region. So they were the ones who helped us also for the better conservation of the monk seals in the region.
It is stormy at Cape Creco, where one of the first marine parks of Cyprus is being developed. A modern approach will be applied. For example, all the fishing will not be prohibited. But getting the support of everyone is not easy.
The biggest challenges for successful creation of marine protected areas are mainly to convince people, and particularly people that their life depends from these areas. For example, professional fishermen, sport fishermen, owner of cruise boats and divers. Fishermen should realize that by protecting marine biodiversity, they will eventually benefit, because you're going to have a recovery of biodiversity and all the fish stocks. So in the long run, they will benefit from this protection.
In the Menes Islands in Spain, the benefits of a marine park are visible already. Even an ordinary tourist can see the recovery of the underwater nature through the windows of a glass-bottom boat. Above the surface, many species of seabirds complete the experience of the visitor. The mooring buoys are one of the conservation measures. The dive boats are tied to these buoys, which protect the sea bottom from anchoring damage. Many marine parks around the world have gotten into difficulties because of problems with funding. In the Menes Islands, the dive boats keep lists on the visiting divers, and a simple but innovative approach helps secure the necessary funds for the park operation.
The divers pay a tax, and this tax is used to finance the operation of the park.
The Menes Marine Park offers something for everyone. One of the secrets behind the success is that those really using the area participate in the development and management of the park. The visitors are also happy to pay for the management when they see the good results with their own eyes. In the Menes waters, there are of course rules of conduct, permitting many uses, but keeping them at the sustainable level has been the key to success. Here, marine protection even helps fishermen get bigger catches in the surrounding areas. Important lessons have been learned.
Marine protected areas need to be open area, and there is no need to close the protected areas to achieve the conservation objectives. There are proven research results showing that marine protected area increased the fish population and therefore the income of fishermen using the protected areas and living around it.
Here, in the Menes Marine Park near Barcelona, conservation needs have been balanced with the uses of the marine resources. As a result, even the big groupers, which had nearly disappeared from the Mediterranean coastal waters, have finally returned. The Menes Park has become a success story, which many countries in the region want to replicate.